morning students. Today we shall discuss about rational and irrational numbers. You might have studied in your previous class what are rational numbers and what are irrational numbers. Rational numbers, I have briefed you in my previous video, the numbers which can be expressed in the form of p by q, where q is not equal to 0. And the numbers which are not rational, they are known as irrational numbers. In 9th class, you might have studied in detail. In 10th class, we have relevant part of syllabus of irrational and rational numbers. This is very important as far as your examination is concerned. You will get a question like this. So that root 2 is a irrational number. Root 2, we cannot have its exact value, that's why it is irrational. But how can we prove it? In mathematics, there is a procedure, there is a method to show that how can you say that the particular number is irrational. And for that, we are going to adopt a method, contradiction. There is a term, contradiction. It means we have to suppose it relevant to the given problem. See, root 2 irrational, root 3 irrational, root 5 irrational, root 7 irrational, root 9 is not irrational. Why? Because we have square root of 9 is 3, and 3 is not irrational number, that is rational. So how we are supposed to prove it? Before we proceed, we are supposed to know co-prime numbers. What are prime numbers and co-prime numbers? Co-prime numbers, those numbers which are having common factor only one. For example, I have considered two numbers, 3 as well as 5. If we take common factor, what we find over here is the common factor is 1. That's why these are known as co-prime numbers. The numbers which are having common factor 1, they are known as co-prime numbers. So let us start. How you are supposed to write its solution? There is a procedure laid down. Let us suppose that root 2 is rational. We are considering it a rational number. Let root 2 is equal to a by b. This is a rational form. And what are a and b? These are co-prime. Co-prime is common factor is 1. Squaring both sides, square of this and square of numerator as well as denominator separately, 2 gets cancelled with square root, because square root itself denotes power 1 by 2. So 2 raised to power 1 by 2 into 2, 2 gets cancelled with 2. That's why we cancel it like this. Then cross multiply. Then we do cross multiply. It becomes 2b square is equal to a square. It means this, if we transpose this 2 to this right hand side, it will divide a square. So you have to write it in this manner. 2 divides a square. If 2 can divide a square, also 2 can divide a. For example, 2 is dividing 16. Clear? 2 can divide 16. But if we consider square root of 16, that is 4, 2 can divide 4 also. That's why this has been mentioned for all numbers. 2 divides a. What does it mean? It means that a is equal to 2c. Means 2 divides a. It means it is multiple of c. 2 into c. C is a some positive integer. Now we have written 2b square is equal to a square. In place of a, you can replace this by 2c. In place of a, 2c has been written over here. And square, it is square. Its square becomes 4c square. 2b square is equal to 4c square. Or you can write it otherwise also. 4c square is equal to 2b square. Get 2 cancelled. Or you can divide both sides by 2. You get 2 square is equal to b square. Now, what this 2 does? It divides b square. That you have to write in this manner. 2 divides b square, also 2 divides b. The same perception whatever we have used over here, same is applied over here. I have already explained you how you are supposed to write 2 divides b. Then see, 2 is dividing b, 2 is dividing a. It means common factor is 2. Common factor is 2. So, but we have assumed in the very beginning common factor must be 1. Therefore, common factor is 2. Common factor is 2, which is the contradiction. It means we have assumed common factor 1, but here we are getting common factor 2. This is known as a contradiction. Means whatever we have supposed, that becomes automatically wrong. Our supposition is wrong. What does it actually mean? Our supposition is wrong. Therefore, root 2 is irrational number. You get a question of similar type in final board examination. This is my experience. And if you have any problem, you can let me know in comment box, in comment section. I can brief you later. I can clarify your doubts as well. I think you might have enjoyed this session very much. Okay, thank you so much.